everyone, and happy Friday. Welcome to our October 20th episode of the Seneca Scout. We have lots of exciting news about SV sports and academics, and some national news you may have missed. We're excited to get started. I'm Cadence Kilhoff.
And I'm Ileana James. The Raiders won a big football game last Friday against the North Hills Indians with a final score of 46-25. The offense dominated with quarterback Sean O'Shea throwing for four touchdowns and scoring a rushing touchdown on a 40-yard run. Wide receivers Kai West and Luke Challingsworth both had good games, earning multiple receptions each. Kai West had a great game as in addition to his offensive prowess, he had an interception. Gold leg Jake Adams had a perfect game going 6 for 6 for extra points. In the first quarter, the game went back and forth. The Indians jumped out to an early lead with an incredible kickoff return that put them inside the red zone. Going into the half, the Raiders led by 1 point, 17-16. In the third quarter, the Raiders widened the lead and never looked back, finishing the game with a 21-point lead. Post-game, Coach Butchley congratulated his team on the win, reiterating that the season wasn't over yet. Raiders have two remaining games on the season against two difficult opponents. First, they will visit the Central Catholic Vikings today, and next week, the face-off for the final game of the year against their rivals, the North Allegheny Tigers. Good luck tonight.
Let's check in with our very own girls volleyball team and see how they are wrapping up their season as they head into playoffs.
The Seneca Valley girls...
journey with Seneca Valley girls volleyball. I'm not happy, I'm sad, but it'll be like cool to see how their season ends up like turning out.
Yeah, looking forward to the most about playoffs.
Watching the girls team win. Woo!
Kennedy, what was the hardest part of this year's season?
Probably obviously the losses are pretty tough, you know. Being injured and everyone being injured and trying to play through injuries.
Tell us more about what you're excited for playoffs.
I am excited to continue growing with the team and building connections with everybody.
Teamwork and just the whole team and the friendships that come from the sport. I also like just like how fun the game is and like how competitive it is at some times, because it really just like challenges each and every one of us to do our best, and I think it brings out the best in everybody.
This season's been so much fun, especially with all the underclassmen. They did a great job making our signs and trashing our house before senior night, and they just made it so much fun.
What has happened this volleyball season? Positives, negatives, anything?
I would say JV all around all season has been really great, and since I've joined varsity with you guys, we have had, I mean, it's been a lot of fun, but it's also been a lot of wins and a lot of work, and I was really proud of us at our tournament at Norwin. Big win there, defeated USC twice, destroyed them. That was really fun. That was a good memory, and I'm just excited to, you know, destroy the Tigers in the Whippoorwills. Thank you.
The Seneca Valley girls golf team had a fantastic year. They recently placed second in the Whippoorwill, which is the first time an SV golf team has placed in the Whippoorwill. Lahini Wanira, a senior on the team, has named a medalist at the 3A State Championships PIAA Sports on the October 17th. This isn't the only accomplishment she has done. For more information on girls golf, we are joined by Lahini.
Hello everyone, I am here with Lahini Ranawira. How are you doing today?
I'm doing great.
That is great. I have a few questions for you. So how did you start getting into golf?
My dad was the first person who got me into it. He used to play a lot, and so I'd watch him swing, and I eventually got interested in the game around, I think, when I was 6.
And what do you think your biggest accomplishment was this season?
I think this season it was just helping my team get to the state tournament, which is something that hasn't ever happened before in the history of the program. So I'd say helping my team get there.
Can you give me an example of sometime this season that the team had to overcome a challenge?
There were a couple matches that we lost during our varsity season that at the time seemed pretty critical. So that kind of took down our morale a bit, but we still kind of kept going and kept our heads up, and we eventually got to where we wanted to be.
And why do you think that was? What made the team so successful after you had those setbacks?
I think just the genuine love that we all have for the game. It's very much an upbeat and community-based team. We aren't solely focus on our accomplishments. So I think that sort of sense of just joy around the game is what helped us get to where we are.
And that is awesome. Congratulations again.
Thank you.
Back to you, Illy.
And now we move to another great SV sports season. The Seneca Valley boys soccer has won another section championship, making it their sixth section championship. The Seneca Valley boys soccer team was tied 0-0 with the North Allegheny Tigers last Thursday night until the second half when Seneca Valley player Tyler Prex scores the tied turning score, the score 1-0. Then quickly followed by Cole Kamarik scoring another goal, securing the win for Seneca Valley. And now a quick interview with Tyler Prex.
It was very important. We haven't lost a section in, I can't remember the last time we have, or lost a game, so this was a huge game for us. It was awesome. We felt something coming. We couldn't get it done in the first half, so it felt great to come out as soon as, like, first minute in the second half and get a goal. And then we knew we had it from there. We have a playoff game, not this Saturday, the next Saturday against Norwin, who we previously played already this year, and we beat them 5-1. So hopefully we can get through them and see who we play in the next round.
Congratulations to the team. Transitioning from athletics to academics, let's learn more about the resources that Seneca Valley has for its students planning for life after high school. Let's check in with Sophia.
Here at Seneca Valley, one of the things that Seneca Valley students worry about the most is what they're going to do with their future. Many students don't realize that Seneca Valley has a college and career center that helps students choose what they want to do with their future and how to do it. There are multiple staff members in room 2B and 2A to help you talk about your future. Okay, can you tell me a little bit about what's going on here?
Hi, this is one of our college speaker series, and this is about financial aid and scholarship searches to help you pay for colleges.
What do you expect to learn here today?
That I can learn how to financially pay for college.
Yes, the College and Career Center is conveniently located on the second floor. I work closely, of course, with all the school counselors on campus, but I also work closely with Mr. Stebbins, Mr. Roberts. Robertson, our IT person as well. When students come to the library, they have questions, anything about college and career. The room that we're meeting in right now is actually a small conference room where all the college representatives, military, they will sign up. If you want to meet with these professionals, that's what this room is for in the College and Career Center. But I know I want to basically say that this center is for students who need assistance. If they needed assistance with a college application, if they need assistance with school links, if they need assistance with, you know, figuring out, you know, what they want to do after they graduate, they certainly can come in. They could Teams me, but this would be the place that we would meet. Also, other applications. There are scholarship applications. There are also job applications. So the College and Career Center is whatever your future plan may entail, you know, and it's always good to have Plan A, Plan B, and Plan C. You certainly could get assistance here in this area. So,
students who are interested in getting any kind of help for college can contact Ms. Leitner on Teams or go to room 2A or 2B.
Thank you, Sophia. And now moving on to national news. With advancements in DNA technology, the Lakelander killer has been found 37 years later. In 1986, Teresa Scalf was brutally murdered in her Lake Home, Florida house. According to detectives and the police, she had significant defensive wounds. There were no obvious suspects at the time, though there was blood left at the scene that didn't belong to Scalf. Quote, the sample remained unmatched to any known individuals, officials say. So sadly, the case went cold. But in 2022, the local sheriff's department teamed up with a private laboratory that specializes in forensics genetic genealogy in cold case investigations. They were able to narrow down the suspects to Donald Douglas, a man who was a prime suspect back in 1986 through DNA obtained by one of Douglas's sons. They were able to conclude that the blood at the crime scene belonged to Douglas. Donald Douglas died of natural causes in 2008, so he can't be brought to justice, but this gives the closure to the family, to the Scalf family.
The mastermind, Taylor Swift, broke box records this weekend with the release of her Eras Tour concert film. Taylor Swift brought in $146 million opening weekend, which made it break the record for best-selling concert film of all time. Just like the Eras Tour, the movie had Swifties dancing, trading friendship bracelets, and dressing up in costumes. Taylor Swift encouraged the community to come out to see the film with exclusive themed items like glow wands, posters, and popcorn buckets. The Eras Tour film is not the only excitement coming out this month. October 27th, 2023, Taylor Swift is re-releasing 1989 Taylor's version. We're excited to finally be able to listen to her version of the album.
Moving from superstar Taylor Swift, we end tonight with some of the most iconic living rockers. Coming out this Friday is the new long-awaited album by the Rolling Stones, titled Hackney Diamonds. This is the first album created after the band's drummer Charlie Watts died in 2021. After creating rock and roll music for the past six decades, Keith Richards, Mick Jagger, and Ronnie Wood decided to challenge themselves after their 2022 tour came to an end. The goal was to create an album and have finished it by Valentine's Day. This challenge resulted in Hackney Diamonds being the Rolling Stones' first album of original songs in 18 years. Wood, who plays the bass guitar for the group, says that making a record now is no different from making one 40 years ago. He says, quote, "Something happens, which is magic, and we never try to examine it that closely. We just let it rock on," end quote. This doesn't mean that the end for the infamous band, though. With thoughts of a new tour arising, even with Jagger and Richards at the age of 80, the band is still going strong.
Thank you for joining us this evening, everyone. Have a great night.
Bye.